Shooting, running, jumping, music from the 1950s, and settlement building. Fallout 4. Fallout 4 is a post-apocalyptic, open-world, action, role-playing game developed by Bethesda Game Studios. It's the fifth installment in the Fallout series, set within an open-world, post-apocalyptic environment that encompasses the city of Boston and the surrounding Massachusetts region, known as the Commonwealth. However, this game is so much more than just that to me. So this game ran a huge pre-engagement campaign. From pre-releases, to teaser trailers, to gameplay trailers, to online reviews, to marketing events, and even to TV advertisement. Interestingly enough, in what I can only describe as delusionary, I managed to not see any ads, not watch any trailers, and not read any reviews. As far as I was aware, this game didn't exist. Fallout as a series was not even a game I'd played or knew anything about. My engagement in the game, in fact, happened by complete and utter fluke. So, in 2015, when me and my friend made the shocking discovery that our PS3 version of NBA 2K16 did not have all the illustrious features we so desired, I decided to buy a PS4 in secret. And, as it happened, the cheapest deal on the market was a package deal that had, guess what, Fallout 4. And despite having zero nostalgic connection and truly no pre-established psychological engagement, I fell in love with the game. But I didn't just fall in love with the game, I fell in love with one particular aspect of the game, and that was settlement building.
Can't come in, I know you've been drinking gin, you've been cheating around with other men, I'm busy and you can't come in.
And it was through the settlement building aspect of the game that Barbaros's six needs were satisfied. The materialism of the resource requirements of each settlement. It relied on object hoarding and storing. The power you felt over the settlers and the control over how they lived, the crops that they ate and the settlements they actually lived in. The affiliation of almost exclusively playing the game with my couched friend, designing and planning and researching our next builds. The achievement of hitting goals and requirements of each settlement. The information we learnt from researching building techniques and compiling knowledge of more and more aspects of the game, and finally, the central experience of the game, the visuals of design and building more beautiful and daring structures. I mean, this was particularly prevalent for me as it came at a time in my life when I was trying to figure out what my next step was and what aspect of design I really wanted to go down. I was so creatively frustrated at the time, and this provided such a new and inspiring creative outlet. On a number of occasions, I was actually able to achieve Mihai Kismet-Mali's illustrious flow state, playing hours upon hours, on occasion all night until morning, designing, building, and furnishing new settlements. I experienced a number of Kismet-Mali's flow state factors. I had intense and focused concentration. My conscience was wholly enveloped into the game. I lost reflectiveness of self-conscious. I lost myself literally to the game. I had a sense of complete personal control over the situation. For those hours, I was the hand of God. I had a distortion of the temporal experience completely. I'd lost my sense of time. Time flowed in a regular manner. I would also experience Kenda Cherry's additional condition to the theory of feeling so engrossed in the experience that other needs become negligible. I lost my sense of hunger, my sense of thirst, and even my concept of tiredness. There are endless amounts of theory I could talk about in relation to Fallout 4. Freud can tell you my desires behind why I play it. Jung can define why my extroversion lends itself to the game's stimuli. Even Lacan's three orders can define, in a very French accent, the imaginary, the symbolic, and the reality behind the game to me. And none of that would be possible for me without Fallout 4. I wouldn't be learning about these theorists, I wouldn't be learning how to make games, and I wouldn't be looking like a tool on this video. It was my love for Fallout 4, the creativity it allowed me, the inspiration it gave me to sign up to this course and study games. This game is quite literally the reason I'm sitting here before you in black and white and looking like I'm from the 1950s. And it's for that reason that this game will always hold a special place in my heart.